Niobium technology is being successfully applied to develop a new generation of smart windows. The glass used in the smart windows can selectively reduce the amount of heat and light that comes through them, enabling a dynamic response to changes in weather conditions and seasons. Adapting the environment inside the building makes them more comfortable and energy efficient. With heating, lighting and cooling making up to 50% of energy use in commercial and residential buildings, the impact of this new technology is significant in terms of reducing CO2 emissions and providing cost savings for consumers. Let's hear from a leading researcher in this exciting new technology.
I'm Delia Milliron. I'm a professor of chemical engineering at the University of Texas at Austin. I've been here for 4 years, and I lead a research team who are developing smart window technologies and other electronic and optical devices using nanocrystal-based materials. My background is in chemistry and material science, and I spent time working at IBM and at Lawrence Berkeley National Lab before coming to UT Austin. So there are a number of types of mechanisms on the material level that can create smart glass or smart window functionality. Some materials are thermochromic, meaning that they respond directly to changes in temperature to adjust the amount of light that transmits or the amount of heat that transmits through the glass. The materials we've been working on that involve niobium oxide are electrochromic, meaning that we apply an electric charge to the glass or the window, and we can change its optical transmittance properties on demand. So that gives us full control using a building control system or actually a switch on the wall that the user can control to adjust the tint on a window and to adjust the amount of heat that comes in from the sun. So that's really the ultimate solution to maximize energy efficiency and also the user experience of the smart window. Our electrochromic glass is able to operate in 3 modes and to continuously switch between them. In the bright mode, the glass is highly transmitting to both visible and infrared light. And then as we apply a voltage, a current flows into the electrochromic material in the glass. And initially, at moderate voltage, it collects in the material that switches in the infrared. So this allows the glass to get in what we call a cool mode, where it's still highly transparent to visible light, and we can harness the daylight power of the sunlight in our building. But it's blocking some of the unwanted heat gain by preventing infrared light transmittance. As we continue to apply a voltage at a higher level, another current flows into the glass, and this collects now also in the niobium oxide material, which tints visibly. So it starts to block visible light as well. And depending on how much current flows in, we can tint to a variable extent. And in this way, we're able to get into what we call our dark mode, where the glass is blocking both visible light and infrared light. And this minimizes the solar heat gain and also helps control for glare so that the space can be most visibly comfortable for the occupants. In my research group, we've been particularly interested in developing smart window technologies that can independently control the visible and the infrared light transmission. These are the two major components of sunlight. And by separating our modulation of visible and infrared light, we can control heating and lighting separately. And these are two major energy uses in buildings. So by managing them independently in response to our needs, we can really make the most universally applicable and the greatest energy saving smart window technology possible. In order to achieve what we call this dual mode, visible and infrared electrochromism, we need two different materials that can manage these two parts of the sunlight. We've used plasmonic materials to handle the IR, and we use niobium oxide for its distinct voltage response to handle the visible light modulation. So looking forward, it's really nice to be partnering with CBMM. They are providing the niobium oxide precursors that we use at the front end of our development process. So being able to work with those materials now as we're in these early stages of development is going to help us transition the technology to manufacturing. And they'll be ready to partner with the commercial partners that take this through to the through to the market. So one of those partners for us is Heliotrope Technologies, which is a company I co-founded a few years ago, has licensed our initial technologies in this area and is working to establish the scaled-up manufacturing that's necessary to demonstrate that prototypes can meet the standards of the industry so that they can move ahead to full-scale manufacturing in the coming years.